All right, we're on the eve of impeachment, the second impeachment. This first one should have gone through, but the Republicans were lockstep against having a proper trial a year ago. And so America got stuck with a coup d'etat at the Capitol. Let's talk more about this Trump insurrection at the Capitol. What happened? The Trump administration was in full collapse this week. You remember? A couple weeks ago? That's the way we remember it. It was in collapse after that coup d'etat. At that time, Trump supporters had launched an assault on the U.S. Capitol, killing a police officer, injuring dozens of more, leaving the nation deeply shaken. Before the riot, the government leader, the President Trump, told a crowd of rabid supporters that election had been stolen and to watch on the Capitol warning, if you don't fight like hell, you're not going to have a country anymore. A mob of thousands then smashed windows, broke down doors, ransacked the offices, smeared feces in hallways, and sent panicked lawmakers into hiding, delaying the certification of Joe Biden's election win. Armed with flex cuffs and tasers, some sought out Vice President Mike Pence and House Speaker Nancy Pelosi, several legislators who'd only narrowly escaped the mob, and they feared for their lives. They said, you remember all that? Five people died in the melee, including a police officer attacked with a fire extinguisher and a QAnon follower shot by a police. Rioters were seen beating a prone cop with sticks and an American flag. Others erected a gallows and a noose outside the Capitol to hang Pence and other traitors. More than 70 of the rioters, whose ranks included firefighters, police officers, active duty military, and business owners, along with members of the militia and white supremacist groups, have been arrested. Actually, 170 have been arrested, but that's far too few. And charges may be including as little as trespassing, assault on police, theft of national security information, and a felony murder. The number of arrests will grow geometrically, supposedly, but so far we've only seen 100 arrested. The games of the gamut of cases we're looking at is mind-blowing to say, but again, we've seen very few arrests. Blowback against Trump and his congressional allies came in from multiple fronts. The House impeached Trump for the second time. That's what we're going to get tomorrow. Over a dozen administrators officially resigned, including DeVos, of Education, Transportation Secretary Elaine Chao, and the former Chief of Staff Mick Mulvaney. The PGA canceled Trump's PGA Championship golf course event in 2022. And Trump's longtime creditor, Deutsche Bank, said no more. We're not going to deal with you. Meanwhile, law enforcement officials warned lawmakers of a host of ominous new threats, including plots to disrupt their inauguration. That cost us how much to have the inauguration this year? Because these coup d'etats have not been fully arrested and brought into line. Because we have not been really taking care of domestic terrorism since I don't know when. More attacks on foreigners than anything. The nation faces a continuing crisis. In other words, it's not over yet. Maryland Rep. Jamie Raskin notes, President Trump has abased his office and should be finished as a serious political figure, said Wall Street Journal. He incites a direct assault on our cornerstone of democracy, the peaceful transfer of power. When his followers turned violent, he declined far too long to call them off. When he finally addressed the mob, he spouted more lies about stolen elections. All this is crosses the constitutional line time and again, and is impeachable. He doesn't have the grace to resign, but he should. Anyway, that was what we did before he got kicked out of office. Anyways, as of the time Joe Biden moved in. Now his cronies and the Republican Party are refusing to actually listen and look at the charges. They're trying to say it's against the Constitution to try a person in Congress. And that's a bunch of crap. They've been doing it since the 1860s or even earlier. Anyway, sorry about that language. Trump's congressional neighbors are complicit in the deadly violence, said the St. Louis Post-Dispatch. That's the same state where I live in. And Senator Josh Hawley, Ted Cruz, and all other two-faced, lying, populist factionist politicians failed repeatedly to stand up and condemn Trump's
dangerous rhetoric. We're still, the Holy is not being censored like he should be, and the Missouri state government should call him home or have some sort of recall for this guy. Anyway, now they deserve to be cast into political purgatory. But again, the Republicans are not doing the right thing. They're suddenly calling for unity and healing, noted the Washington Post. There's a minimum price of entry for reconciliation. Issue an unequivocal acknowledgement that there was no vote rigging and Joe Biden won fair and square. But they refused to do it. 134 congressmen and several senators. And they expect Americans to forget this? Anyway, the responsibility for this horrific spectacle fell squarely on Donald Trump. And he incited his followers for weeks and made baseless claims of election fraud, misled them into believing Pence could alter the outcome of the certification vote, and then sent them seething the crowds and mobs with the rage to the Capitol. At each step, Trump could have steered his supporters away from violence, but no, he could not. He did not. He would not. He chose the opposite path every step of the way. The blame runs far deeper than Trump, said Zach Beauchamp. Of course, it runs the Fox News and the gamut of all kinds of social media that didn't get him under their toe months ago, years ago. Same thing for Time Magazine and the others. For years, the GOP has vilified Democrats as extremists who represent an existential threat to America, they've been saying, and whose election victories are inherently fraudulent, and they've proved themselves to be more criminal than any government I knew in my early years, starting in the 1970s. The legitimizing rhetoric has long fueled the conservative movement, and Capitol violence was a logical step. That's what I say. And it's not only me, but a lot of people in Vox.com and other newspapers say the same thing, including 538. It was an explosion of rage by whites who see their domestic dominance threatened by a multiracial coalition of Americans who brought Biden to power, carrying thick Confederate flags they weren't, and Jewish flags of all things, just to defend Trump, but also to defend a white American whose hold on power has become increasingly precarious. And I think that the Republican Party should be made precarious. I'm thinking of running for office against two senators in the next 2 to 4 years. The overriding the question now, said Charlie Sykes in Bulwark.com, is where this was the last gasp of Trumpist air. But it wasn't, and it hasn't been until Trump really gets slammed. I want to see at least 16 senators join with Democrats this coming week. Slam dunk. We'll pray for them and pray for the souls that they actually do the right thing. Faced with the consequence of putting a demagogue in power, some Republicans are crawling out from the detritus of Trumpism and trying to return a modicum of sanity. I don't believe we've had it. And I'm trying to imitate them right now by the way they talk. This is how they talk to you, America. Anyway, but we remain a deeply divided country, and dark days may lie ahead. They certainly will. Unfortunately, it's just one small step from coup d'etat to civil war. I want to keep this short and remind you why we're impeaching Trump, why he was impeached, and he needs to be forbidden from running for any office forever, not even dog catcher. And I say this with the same anger that Tom Cruise, that Senator Hawley, oh my gosh, these guys should have been put in jail long ago for inciting violence in America, don't you think? I think so. And I will continue imitating them and speaking like them until they get kicked out. I love you guys. Thank you for watching and listening to the tirade, and help us make a better country, because that's what we're all about. We do want to have love, and we do want to have forgiveness, but we also need to have some love, law and order, peace, and justice. If Americans don't long of the Trump clan, and if the GOP clan don't want justice anymore, we make sure they get kicked out of office in 2022. Anyway, God bless you guys. I hope you don't get
get ill and remain healthy. Take care.